Good morning, Friday. Hey, y'all. Hey there. Happy Friday. Grab your coffee. So I'm not sure if you saw my post earlier this week, but we used to do a thing at the YMCA. Good morning, Pamela. Every Friday, we would deem that Wacky Pants Friday. So I've tried to dig out some of my wacky pants from the archives. Here they are. They're black on one side and striped on one side. Good morning, Kristina. So I know this may be late to the party telling you guys, but if you saw the post, you knew to wear your wacky pants on Fridays, okay? Good morning, Barbara, Kenya, Kristina. So yes, it is Friday, which means we all have a little bit more pep in our step. It's a little bit more exciting when it's Friday for some reason. The coffee just tastes a little bit better, knowing that we made it through another week together, y'all. Good morning, Kenya, Anita, Yolanda, Carol. Hey, y'all. So it is Wacky Pants Friday. If you want to get into the habit with us, just to make it a little bit of fun on Fridays. We're just trying to do something different. Also, today's workout is abs. I asked four of our regular students, Kristina Alexander, Michael Owens, Michelle Fryer, and Barbara Bradley, to come up with some ideas for today. Good morning, Carol. Good morning, Dee Dee. Hey, y'all. Thank you, Emily. So on one side, they're like a stripe. I don't know if you can see that. They're like a stripe. And then the other side, they're black. What's really fun, they're not technically reversible, but you can reverse them and do the black on the front. It's kind of fun. So for today's workout, you will need some heavy weights, some light weights, and a mat, okay? All right, let me set the coffee down. Come on, Jess. You gotta work out at some point. I'm gonna turn up the music just a hair. All right, let's start with a warm-up, you guys. Here we go. Let's start with a side-to-side hop. Start very low impact. Basically just a tap, side to side. Here we go. Let's get our bodies warmed up. That's it, Emily. That's it, Dee Dee. Now start getting a little bit of a bigger hop. Bigger hop. Landing on one leg. We are trying to wake up our bodies, first off. Wake up. Step one, stretch. Step two. That's it, five more. Five, four, three, two, one. Good, good. Let's do a squat with a stretch. Squat, stretch, squat, stretch. That's it. Good job. There's Juanita. Squat, reach. Good, y'all, wake up. Wake up, Friday. Let's get this last workout of the week done. Good. Let's just go and do a few more body weight squats. Good morning, Trisha. Good morning, Lolita Maria. A couple more body weight squats. Good. Now let's go into a sumo stance. So if you did all the workouts with us this week, I tell you what, I've still got some soreness from Wednesday's leg day, a little bit in my glutes from yesterday's kettlebell swings. All right, let's go side to side. Go into a static lunge and go to the other side. There you go. Good morning. There's Tanya Dennis. She's been serious, dedicated here every day this week. So proud of you, Tanya. That's it. A couple more stretches, you guys. I'll tell you where I feel like I need to stretch. It's just in my hamstrings. Just hang your body weight to the floor. Oh, walk it around to the left. That's it. Walk it around to the right. side. Let's do one big cardio to get our heart rate up. Jumping jacks, let's go for 30. Remember, you can do a low jack if you have any knee problems, or a full jack. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good. So if you heard me posting or saw me posting earlier this week, we used to do this cool thing at the Y, because every day there you had to wear black pants. But on Fridays, they let you wear whatever pants you wanted. So officially now, I'm gonna try to keep up with it. Fridays, we're making it Wacky Pants Friday. So if you have anything super wacky that you've not pulled out of your closet lately, I'd love for you to wear them to celebrate with me that it's Friday, okay? Here's the first circuit. We've got side bends. We've got a V-up, which she calls an in and in outs, alternating toe touch, and a ball pass. So if you do not have a ball, which I have one in the garage, I haven't blown it up, you're gonna use a pillow for that, okay? So if you do not have a stability ball, grab your pillow and keep that handy, okay? Let's start with the heavy side bends. Grab a heavy weight. We had these on yesterday's workout, but there's no reason why we can't do them 2 days in a row. So it's right here, okay? And if you have two weights, you can always do two side bends on either side. I'm gonna try that today. They're not exactly the same size, but I'm going with it anyway. Here we go for side bends, y'all. First circuit, ready? Let's do it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That's it, Tanya. 8, 9, 10, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now, if you're using two weights like me, switch them real quick. And let's do 15 on the other side for a total of 30, okay? Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, that's it. 5, I'm using double weights. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 5, 4, work it on those obliques. 3, 2, 1. Good. All right, set your weights down. Now let's go to your mat for your in and outs, AKA V-ups, okay? There's Milo. Hey, Milo kitty. Hey, buddy. All right, sit back, hands behind you, feet out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, get to 20, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. Good. Christina's next favorite was the alternating toe touch. So let's go all the way back. Body weight only. You're gonna be in like an X formation. So you're gonna go 1 and 2, just like that. Ready? Here we go for 20. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Keep it going. 9, 10, halfway, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17.
17, 18, 19, and 20. Good, roll it up.
All right, the fourth move in the circuit is the ball pass or a pillow pass, okay? If you've got the pillow, just squeeze it between your feet. You're passing it from your feet to your hands for 20. Ready? Here we go. Every time it touches your hands, that's considered one. Hey, Odie. I don't know what's going on with all these cats this morning. They've suddenly decided to hang out with me. Come on, guys. This is usually their outside hour. I'm laying back, dude.
Get out of the way. Here we go. One. Two.
Good collection of four. Again, inspired and brought to you by Kristina Alexander. All right, we've got two more of that same circuit, okay? Get water real quick. You know what? I can start to feel some sweat coming down. Hey, Beverly. All right, here we go. So with those side bends, if you have two heavy kettlebells, there'll be one side that'll be your primary side, and then we're gonna switch. If not, keep the same weight and just do half and half, okay? Either way, trying to just get a little bit more work out of the side bends. I'm gonna make this heavy weight my primary side, that side. Here we go. One, two, three, four, five, that's it, side bend, six, this is round two, seven, eight, nine, 10, that's it, Yvette, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15, good, switch weights. I'm using a 20 and a 25, here we go, this is the primary side, one, two, three, not only is it Friday, four, five, but it's a long holiday weekend, six, seven, I've been getting some questions, eight, are we working out on Monday, nine, 10, the answer is yes, five, four, three, two, and one, good, but it will be on a holiday schedule. So I don't think there's anyone who has to work, who has to get up at 5 a.m. on the holiday. Am I right? I know there are some nurses. We're gonna work out at 8 o'clock, okay? We've got about a 45 to an hour workout. V-ups. One, two, three, four, five. Second round. Six, seven, eight, nine, 10. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good. Lay it back. You've got the alternating toe touch, okay? So on Monday, we've got a workout plan by Yolanda. It's going to be a full body boot camp type format for 1 hour class from 8 to 9. Here we go. Toe touches, lay in an X. Here we go. One, alternating. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine,
Halfway. 11. 12. 13. 14. 15. 16. 17. 18. 19. And 20. Good. Roll it up.
And then my spin class last night, they were like, can we do spin also? So I said yes. So immediately following the 8 o'clock boot camp, we're going to do a 9 o'clock spin class. It's going to be express spin, so about 45 minute spin class. Here we go with the pillow pass. Fourth movement, round two.
One. Two. Three. Every time it touches your hands, four. Five. That counts. Six. Seven. Keep your legs straight. Eight, if you can. Nine, if you have to. 10, bend them a little bit. 11. 12. 13. 14. 15. 16. 17, 18, last two, 19, 20.
Good, roll it up. Pillow to the side, y'all. Here is your water break, okay, Yvette? So somehow, in the midst of spin class, they said, can we do a spin class too? So if you have a spin bike, you better be there. So that'll be our Monday holiday schedule. 8 o'clock, this, and then a 9 o'clock, that. All right, round three coming up, you guys. Heavy side bends, okay? You know what this is, right? Collagen coffee. I swear by the collagen. Definitely helps me feel less creaky. If you're still experiencing some joint pain, good morning, Anya. She made it. Yes. Here we go. Heavy side bends. Pick a side that's going to be your primary side for the first 15. One. Two. There's Regina. Three. She made it. Four. Five. Six. Jump in on side bends. Seven. Eight. Nine. 10, last five. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good, switch those weights. If you're using two different weights, only if. 1, 2, 3, side bend. 4, 5, 6, this circuit. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, go deeper, 12, 13, 14, 15, there's Norma. That's it, y'all. I almost went to 20. But again, today's circuits are all designed by you guys. Each little segment was inspired by, suggested by, curated by the students. Here we go. She calls these in and outs. I said, is that V up? One, two, three, four, five. Knees up. Six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 10, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Good, lay it all the way back. Here we go, this is the alternating toe touch.
So lay back like the letter X. Here we go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20.
Good, roll it up. A lot of today's work is being done from your mat. So just consider this day like a stretch relaxation day, right? Since we're not swinging heavy kettlebells around. Here we go, pillow pass. Last one for 20, and then we're moving on to Michael's workout. Here we go.
One, two, three, or stability ball. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20.
Good, y'all. Sit it up. All right, here is your transition. We've got a new circuit coming up. Grab some water or coffee or whatever you got and let's talk, okay? So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4 moves in the Michael circuit. You may have met Michael, my boyfriend, you may not have, but he considers himself an ab guru, okay? So whenever, and I'm like, hey, you do realize I'm a trainer, right? I know what I'm talking about. And he's like, yeah, do this. So I was like, hey, help me plan today's workout. So we've got 4 of his favorites on the list, and he might even be joining in watching. So if you are, hey, babe. Here we go. Here's his 4 favorites, and some of his favorites other people picked, so I made him pick something new. We've got a standing twist. You can either do it like this, or there's another way you can do it. You can take a very, very light weight and set it right here. That helps you to put your arms back, so when you twist, you actually are forced to pull your elbows back, okay? So that is the way he recommended it. He also said if you had like a broomstick or something, you could put that back there. So my broomstick is in the shop currently. So I decided to use this weight. Then we're gonna go to our mat and do L-shaped abs. Then we're gonna do it's a crunch with your toes up. And then we're gonna do a static plank, okay? Here we go. Stand with your shoulder width, feet with shoulder width apart. Put that weight right here on a comfortable spot on your shoulders, and you're going to turn and pivot just like that, a standing twist. Here we go.
1, 2, 3,
elbows back.
4,
twist.
5, 6,
holding that weight.
7, 8,
just forces your elbows out.
9, 10,
halfway.
11,
twist.
13,
pivot your foot.
14, 15, 16,
17, don't get dizzy.
18, 19, and 20.
Good, come out of there with that light weight. Good morning, Norma. Just make sure you don't hit your neck, okay? All right, go to your mat, y'all. We've got L-shaped abs. We did these one time and we didn't know what to call them. So this is what was at one point known as the Michael. I think Yolanda suggested that. It's L-shaped where you're gonna go up and out, okay? Working both sets. We've got 20 total. Each one counts as one. Here we go, you can put your hands underneath your lower back if you choose. Let's go. First, up, out. 2, 3, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5, 6,
12, 13, lower abs, 14, 15, 5 more, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. That's it, y'all. Come up.
All right, I know I changed course in there. I was like, each one will count as one. But then I realized each set of two needs to count as one. All right, the toe touch, you're gonna lay on your back, feet to the sky. It's basically like a toe up crunch, okay? You're gonna try to get your shoulder blades off the mat.
So it looks like this. Toes up, and one, two, just like that, okay? Here we go. One, two, three, four, crunch, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Good.
All right, last one is a static plank. I'm gonna try to count us down. I don't have a timer handy, but I'm gonna do my best. I want you to go into a straight arm plank. I'm gonna count. We're gonna try to hold it for a minute. Ready? Here we go. Go up. Here we go. That's 10 seconds. That sure felt like 10 seconds. What I really need right now is a stopwatch. Or I could get out my Tabata timer for the next round. All right, you're at 20 seconds, y'all. Hang in there. Keep your hips low. Hips low. Keep breathing. You're at 30 seconds. Keep, hang in there. You're halfway. Keep breathing. A static plank is building the inner sheath, which holds all your guts in. All right, you're at 40 seconds. Breathe. Breathe. All right, 10 seconds. Here we go. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good. Now, I know that wasn't official counting, but you get the idea. Next round, we will absolutely use the Tabata timer. All right, you guys, breathe, get some water. Let me set up the timer. All right, get coffee. I hope those four make sense. Michael's favorite. Get some water, get coffee. We're gonna start with the standing twist, round two. Okay, you guys ready? Grab your hand weight. You're gonna start with a standing twist. Here we go. Round two of the Michael. Toe touch for tall girls. Sorry. Here we go. Weight up, elbows back. One, let's go 10 to one side. Two, three, four, five, six, pivot, seven, eight, we're going to one side, nine, and 10. Good, go back to center, go to the other side for 10. One, two, elbows back, three, are you twisting? Four, look behind you, five, six, seven, eight, I'm looking at the little Debbie, nine, and 10. Good, bring it up. All right, L-shaped abs. Here we go, lay it all the way back. And yes, in case you're wondering why I have a poster of Little Debbie behind me, in case you're wondering and you haven't heard the story, it is actually my Iron Man poster from last year. A friend of mine had that framed for me, and Little Debbie was the sponsor of the Iron Man, okay? So that's why her face is on my wall. Not because I love Little Debbie's. Ready? Here we go. L-shaped abs. We're gonna go up for two, out for two. Ready? Here we go. One. One. Two. Two. Three. Three. Four. Four. Five. Five. Six. Six. Seven. Seven. Eight. Eight. Nine. Nine. Hang in there. Ten. Ten. 11. 11. 12. 12. 13. 13. 14. 14. 15. 15. 16. 16. 17. 17. 18. 18. 19. 19. Last one. 20 and 20. Good. Roll it up. The third move is the toe touch. And if you want to, you don't have to lead with your hands. You can just make that a crunch with your feet up, okay? Here's move three. Go back. Toes up. Here we go. Toe up crunch. One, two, three, four, five, six. Is this better, Pamela? Seven. Eight, nine, that's it, you bet. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. Good. Last one, you're gonna do the static plank. Let me turn on my timer real quick. Work phase. Sorry, once we have it set up, we won't need it. We're gonna hold it for 1 minute. Ready, set, and
starting session.
Here we go. 1 minute plank. Here we go, y'all. 1 minute static hold plank. I should have set that up before we started. But the good news is we're gonna need the timer because I think each round, keep your butt low, each round has a static hold plank in it. Hold it right here. Hold it, hold it. We've got one more round of Michael's workout. As soon as we come out of this plank, I would say we're about halfway. Let's see, yep, halfway. Good. I think after years of timing people, I kind of have a little clock in my head and I can feel what 30 seconds feels like. And I want you to develop those skills too. Static hold plank. I don't want your butt up here. I want it down here. Hips low. That's it. 10 seconds. Good. That is it, y'all. All right, one more set, okay? Stop the timer. Here we go. We're gonna pick up the pace just a little bit. Let's go ahead and start with our twist, our standing twist. Remember, alternating, elbows back. One, two, three, four, twist, five, six. This really works. Seven on that. Eight, trunk rotation. 9, 10, the obliques, 11, 12, twist, 13, 14, I'm getting dizzy, 15,
16, 17, shoulders back, 18, 19, and 20.
Good, come out of it. L-shaped abs. Here we go, go to your mat. We're just gonna do the standard ones, okay? Here we go. You know what, let's do 10 and 10. Hands down, straight up. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, two more, nine, and 10. Now go lateral. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Good, y'all. Let's do 10 more of those connected, okay? Here we go. One, one, two, two, three, three, four, four, five, five, six, six, seven, seven, eight, eight, nine, nine, 10, and 10. Good. Come all the way up. All right, your third one, remember, is a toe up crunch for 20. Ready? Here we go. Toes in the air. Feet up. Crunch for 20. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, halfway, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Roll it up. Plank. I'm gonna hit the timer, okay? Ready? You've got 1 minute plank. Starting now. Here we go, y'all. Last one. And then we're gonna move on to our next circuit. We're gonna jump straight into the Barbara. Because she is in this class today, I wanna make sure we have enough time for her circuit. And then if we get in 2 rounds of the Michelle, we will. Keep your hips low, hips low. Breathe, breathe, you're halfway. Am I right? I was right. I exactly had it right, 30 seconds. Hips low, keep breathing. Static hold plank. Now over time, we should be able to go to 90 seconds and then 2 minutes. A plank is something that you can continue developing that skill. Add 15 seconds each week. 10 seconds. Hips low. Good. Bring it up. There we go, y'all. All right, pull your mat back. Let's talk about the Barbara, okay? Stop.
Stopping session.
Oh, one sip left. All right, how's everybody doing? Yes? 2 down, we're just over the halfway point. All right, the Barbara. You've got an ab roll up. This is the one where if you have a couch or something heavy, you're gonna brace yourself from underneath the couch, okay? If you don't, put a heavy weight back there, okay? And that way you just hold on to your heavy kettlebell. Then we're gonna do flutter kicks. Hanging in there, Juanita. Yes. Then we're going to do a sit-up and a press and a side crunch, okay? These are 4 of Barbara's classes. She literally is the first one to log in every day. I don't know how she does it. I don't know if she's just sitting right there and she's been up for an hour already. But Barbara's very, very much an inspiration, and she is getting those abs, girl. I'm so proud of you. Here we go, an ab roll up. Go to your mat. You're gonna either brace yourself with something or use a heavy weight, okay? Yes. Yes, you are. Here we go. Roll it. Roll it back.
We're gonna go to this guy for 20, y'all. Ready? Here we go. One. Lift your hips up. Two. That's it. Three. Go slow on the decline. Four. Five. Six. That's it. Seven. Eight. Nine. Ten. 11. 12. 13. 14. Woo! 15. Hips up. 16. 17. 18. 19.
I don't know if we've ever done 20 of those. Hey, Bruce. 20 is a lot. Okay, we may reduce that for the next round. Here we go. Lay on your back, flutter kicks. You can go hands underneath your lower back. We're gonna keep it low. This is your very, very lower abs. Here we go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Good. Roll it up. Grab something you can use for your press. I'm gonna grab this 20-pound kettlebell, but you can use your hand weights for this as well. Let's do 10 of these. Here we go.
One. One. Two. Two. Three. Three. Four. Four. Five. Five. Six.
Six. Four more.
Seven. Seven. Eight.
Eight. That's it, Yolanda.
Nine.
Nine. One more.
Ten.
And ten. Good job, Dee Dee. Here we go. Side crunch, y'all. Lay it back. Knees bent. Come on, Tanya. Here we go. Ready? Side crunch.
One. Two. Three. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Good. Roll it up.
Here's your water break. Get a 10-second water break. I need it after that. We're going to adjust a couple of those, okay? So on the ab roll up, it was a lot. It was good, but it was a lot. We're gonna take 10 from the ab roll up, at least 5 or 10, and swing that over to flutter kicks. Like this song. Even though it's a techno mix to it, it's kind of got a nice little groove. All right, ready? Here we go. Ab roll-ups. Go to your mat. Brace yourself underneath the couch or with a heavy kettlebell. Add a twist if you like. Ready? Here we go.
One. Two. Three. Get to 10. Four, five, six, seven, three more,
10 was a lot. Maybe it's because my abs are getting tired. Here we go, flutter kicks. We've got at least 30 of these in us because they're quick and they're fast. Here we go, roll it back.
Ready? Let's do it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, stay low. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Good. Next up, sit up and press. Breathe. Everybody doing okay? I'm loving the Barbara. These are going by quickly, and they're some of my favorites too. Here we go, sit back, sit up and twist with a weight. Sit up and press with a weight, I meant to say.
One.
One.
Two.
Two.
Three.
Three, you got it.
Four.
Four.
Five.
Six.
Seven.
Seven.
Eight. Keep sweating. Eight. Nine.
Nine.
Ten.
And ten. Good. Set your weight down. Lay back. Knees bent for a side crunch.
Here we go. Sit back for 20. Ready? Here we go. Really squeeze. Two. Three. Four. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1.
Here we go. Roll it up. Now, grab a quick drink of water. We've got one more of the Barbara circuit, okay? You guys doing okay? Super focused today, I have to tell you that. There's no extra chit-chat. You guys are doing awesome. And I tell you what, Fridays should feel differently than the rest of the week. We have lifted hard every day. We have been sore every single day. So if today feels like a bit of a deload day, less work than the rest of the week, it should, okay? Absolutely, it should. Last set of these ab roll-ups. If you're struggling, remember, you can just bring your knees up. You just want to feel a crunch right here. Ready?
Here we go.
Brace yourself on something.
Here we go for 10. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Ten.
Good. Next one, flutter kicks. We're gonna go for 30 on this one. Here we go, roll it all the way back.
Hands underneath your lower back. Ready? Here we go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, 11, 12. 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, stay low, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Good. Now on those, you should really be feeling it in your lower abs. All right, here we go. Last set of the sit up and press for 10. We've got this, y'all.
One. One. Two.
Two.
Patricia. Six, seven. That's it, Juanita. Eight, nine. One more, Pamela. 10.
Good. Last set of side crunches. And then we're going to move on to two sets, hopefully one or two sets of the Michelle to finish us off. Side crunch. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Reach. 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Good. Roll it up, y'all. Get water. Bravo. Bravo on finishing the Barbara. We've completed Kristina, Michael, and Barbara. We've got to get to Michelle, okay? Here's your four moves. We'll knock them out quickly. It's a one-arm get-up. You're going to have your arm to the sky, and you're going to go from your knees up. It's really a good core engager. Then you're going to do a Russian twist. You're going to do a bicycle crunch and a forearm plank. Those four movements, okay? Grab your mat, double and triple it up. That way you've got lots of padding for your knees. Here we go. Go ahead and grab one hand weight. Start on your knees. You're going to get up from this position with a weight over your head. Ready? One, and down. Five each side. Two, right here. That's it. Three. Down. Four. Five. Good. Go all the way down. Switch to the other side. Now the arm you're holding up is your lead leg, which is no fun. Ready? One. Two. Three. Last two. Four. Oh, my legs are sore. Five. Good. Now, if you struggle with those because of your knees, you can absolutely turn that into a snatch. You could turn it into a one-arm curl and press. You can do something else with it if you're not able to get to the ground, okay? Take that weight. Let's do a Russian twist for 20. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Russian twist. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Good. Set that down. We're going to go straight into a bicycle crunch, okay? Here we go. There's Maria. Hey, Maria. Here we go. Arms back, knee to elbow. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Good. Bring it up. Get ready for the forearm plank, okay? Forearm plank. I'm going to hit the timer. You've got 1 minute, okay? Ready? Go into your forearm plank and begin. Here we go. Forearm plank. Right here. Forearm plank. Hold it. Keep your hips low. Hips low. Keep breathing, y'all. 15 seconds in. Hips low. I would say this one is harder for me. I can't tell you why, but it's harder. Keep breathing. You're halfway. Keep breathing. That's it. Push your air out. That's it, Juanita. Good job, Dee Dee. That's it, Emily. Breathe. 15 seconds. Five seconds. Good job, y'all. All right. Quick executive decision. We are going to take out the one-arm get-up, but finish with those last three, okay? So let's go straight to a Russian twist. Straight to a Russian twist, y'all. These three moves and we're out of here, okay? Hit your mat. We're skipping the water break. I want to get two rounds into the Michelle, skipping the one-arm get-up. Ready? Russians. One. Two. You can do it. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Ten. 11. 12. That's it. 13. 14. 15. Russian twist. Five more. Four. Three. Two. And one. Good. Lay it all the way back. You can do this, Juanita. Lay it back. Bicycle crunch for 20. Ready? Start with one elbow to knee. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Arrgh. Oh, that's hurting. Here we go. I'm going to start the timer. Get in position for your plank. You've got 1 minute, one plank to go. Dee Dee's got to get to work. All right, see you, Dee Dee. Ready? Plank it out. Forearm plank. Go down. Here we go. Last minute. Last minute of the day. You guys did amazing today. I know we cut it to the very last second, but a lot of days I get you out of here 10 minutes free. So I figured I've been banking those minutes. We can go to the very end. Keep your hips low. That's 20 seconds. Breathe. The key thing on these planks is to breathe. Settle into it. Good. Now for some of us, these are harder than the straight arm. I think it's because I just do these so little. Truthfully. All right, y'all. Keep breathing. You're over halfway. 15 seconds. Reminders for Friday. Keep drinking your water. Keep eating as clean as possible. We've got a big holiday weekend coming up. 3, 2, 1. We've got a big holiday weekend coming up. Probably lots of picnics. Lots of parties. Lots of parties. Lots of fun stuff going on, right? So, as a reminder, don't skip your workouts, okay? On those days, you know you're going to have a family picnic, or you're going to be eating a little banana pudding or whatever it is. Do not skip your workouts on those days. We've got two classes tomorrow. We're going to be doing a booty bar. Booty bar at 8 o'clock, spin class at 9:30. Thank you, Barbara. She's got to get to work. Then on Sunday, that's a rest day. I'm gonna be out on the boat with family. Monday, we've got two classes, but it's a holiday schedule. There will not be a 5 o'clock on Monday. We're gonna do a 8 a.m., one big group training session. Thank you, Beverly. Tanya did great. She said, where's that oxygen tank? I love it. And you guys, over time, I promise you, this area is getting stronger. Hopefully some of those movements felt easier today than they did earlier. And if you're new to us, they're gonna get easier. I promise you, ab day is gonna feel like a rest day, okay? Give it time. And then, so Monday again, we've got 8 o'clock class and then a 9 o'clock spin class, okay, y'all? Thank you, the planks. We're gonna keep working on those planks, Tanya. I promise you, we're gonna get better at those. Thank you, Anya. You guys drink your water and keep tracking today, okay? Love y'all. Thank you, Anita, Yolanda. Bye, you guys. Have a wonderful Friday. Yay, it's Friday. All right, you guys, see ya, bye.